Hello everyone, my name is Svetlana. I live in Western Australia. I am originally from Russia, and I like talking about fragrances. I'm collecting fragrances, and as I said before, the main reason of this channel is to improve my speaking abilities, and I am improving them using the topic of the perfumery. The channel name is a perfumery, which combines name of the place where I live, Perth, the capital city of the Western Australia, and perfumery. So today I will talk about the fragrance with the name Gucci Envy. Many of you may remember this fragrance. I believe it will be one of the fragrances which will be written in any book about fragrances in the future. Why is that? Because it was quite an interesting edition. It was issued in 1997. Those who was not 1 month old in 1997 may remember it, and I got this fragrance when I was 25, I think, in 1998, and it has a lot of nostalgic value for me. Also, I noticed that many people feel different ingredients in this fragrance, and I can say for sure that it doesn't smell like, it's a little bit broken here, you see, this one is broken. You definitely, what you don't feel in this fragrance is vanilla, you don't feel amber, you don't feel oud, but when we start talking about it, you will feel that many people feel different things about this fragrance. It was issued in massive quantities, and it's not really hard to find. If you have a goal to buy this fragrance, one day you will find it. I will talk about condition as well, but it's not too hard to find. There are many fragrances, even more younger fragrances, which is much harder to find these days. The author of the fragrance is Maurice Roussel. He is a genius perfumer, and I like almost everything from him. But this was quite a interesting fragrance for me. So, going now and see what other people saying about the fragrance. So if you open Fragrantica, you will find that the goal of this fragrance to bring a fresh breeze in the city. Yeah, so obviously it was considered as a spring fragrance, as modern. You see the minimalistic shape of the bottle, and if you lived just before 2000, you may remember everything had a minimalistic design. It was a minimalistic gold, minimalistic earrings, minimalistic rings, everything minimalistic. So you see this bottle, and some people say the design of the old bottles is ugly. And I would ask, compare with what? So you will see this design in current Michael Kors fragrances, which are very popular, and nobody says it's outdated. Yeah, it's a fantastic design, simple, nice, urbanistic, I would say. Yeah, it reminds a shape of the skyscraper. Very minimalistic. And what Gucci says about it, the composition starts with green notes and the cool metal note that freezes the senses. Gradually the scent warms up due to woody notes and musk. This metal accord surrounded by a floral bouquet became very popular during the 90s. The notes are hyacinthus, lily of the valley, rose, jasmine, green notes, magnolia, iris, woods, and musk. Everyone remembered it? Yes. For me, it's very simple. For me, it smells the green metallic pineapple. So if like it's like if you cut a pineapple and the smell the knife. Currently, it's the metallic notes are very popular. You can find it in the fragrance Deliria from L'Artisan Parfumier. It's a metallic sweet apple and cotton candy. You can find it in Amouage Opus number 10, which is a metallic rose. You can find it in Nasomatto Fantomas, a new fragrance. It's also sweet notes in with metal. So metallic notes are very popular, but I do not remember any fragrance before this fragrance which comes with metallic notes. So it's clear metal like this. Yeah. So this fragrance was issued in Eau de Toilette version, which I got immediately in 1988, almost after, straight away after it was issued. Then this is a 50 milliliter bottle, and there is a 30 milliliter bottle which looks shorter. Then there were 100 ml bottles, bigger. Yeah, let's see how big it is. Yeah, but exactly same proportions. And this fragrance also was issued in Eau de Parfum. And at the time when it was issued, I didn't see the version or the Parfum version, so I am opening it now. It's in a non-transparent black bottle. It doesn't feel like a glass. It's covered with something interesting. It smells exactly the same. However, if I do the wrist to wrist test, you will find the differences. So this version is smoother and softer than Eau de Toilette version. So EDT version is quite sharp, and I only had EDT version at the time, therefore I'm not craving the EDP version. But if you found this version of fragrance, I probably would recommend you to buy it, provided price is reasonable, because the likelihood that the fragrance keeps well in this bottle is much higher than in this bottle. Yeah. So talk about condition. Since it's sort of hard to find, it's not really hard, I would say. You would really want to buy a fragrance which smells exactly like it meant to be. The problem with this fragrance is that if you keep it on the light, it goes off very quickly. It turns bad and it smells a little bit strange. So I have a version which was not kept in ideal conditions, and you see the difference in color. Yeah, you see that EDT version is lighter and more like an acidic yellow rather than version in a bigger bottle. A bigger bottle smells a little bit strange. So it's now better after it had a rest a little bit with me, and after, yeah, it doesn't smell exactly the same. It doesn't smell really bad, but and after some time, after maybe 5-10 minutes, it starts smelling exactly the same as a well-preserved version. However, please be careful, otherwise you may be disappointed, because it's a slightly different. So also it was a version in Parfum. I never had it, and I am not craving for a Parfum version. I don't really need it. Now, see what other people saying about this fragrance. I have a book of the author Barbara Herman. And the name of the book is Scent and Subversion, Decoding a Century of Provocative Perfume. I think it's a Jacques Fass bottle. It says that the Gucci Envy is a tart green rose that soars with galbanum and coriander and then plummets to earth with a dissonant powdery anise accord with facets of celery and violet leaf. Envy mimics the bipolarity of its namesake emotion. It feels like two different perfumes, so violently does its first half differ from its second. Because I love the galbanum and rose opening, this powdery licorice base tempers my affection for this scent, but I admire its dramatic two-act play. So, the only commonality with the previous description from Fragrantica is that the fragrance has two phases. Yeah? Otherwise, this fragrance opens with rose and galbanum. Yeah? And the base is powdery licorice. I don't feel anything like this. I don't feel rose in this fragrance. I don't feel iris, and I don't feel licorice and powder. So you see, the only commonality with what I feel is the green notes, which are represented by galban. Yeah. Next book. The next book, which refers to Gucci Envy, is Neil Chapman, and the name is Perfume: In Search of Your Signature Scent. I'm still searching. I don't have a signature scent. So what does it say? Envy was the smell of the millennium approaching, a shedding of skins into a new futuristic metallic shares of hyacinth, magnolia and sleek transparent green rose over sheer woods and musk. As popular in Tokyo as it was in London, there was an untouchability to the aura of women who walked the streets in this vindictive breeze of touch me you die Harper, hyper cleanliness and sharp of the moment chic. Mysteriously removed from production, envy lovers now prowl the internet in search of backup bottles to keep the veneer alive. I think this description a little bit closer to what I think about perfume, and I will tell you why. For me, this perfume is very clean. So it's no doubt, it's super clean. And when you go to Fragrantica forum and women ask about something like Femme Fatale fragrance, and people give normally the dark names, yeah? The perfumes in a dark bottle, but this perfume is not dark. It's not dark, it's absolutely light. It's full of light, but this light is not a friendly color. If you look at the back, I have a bunch of chocolate flowers. They're made of paper with the chocolate inside. And I think the Gucci Envy smells like this. It smells something light but poisonous. Not the right perfume got the name poison, yeah? So, for me, it's like a young and virgin woman. The Vierge de Fer, yeah? Serge Lutens, the girl in metal, yeah? It's like Jeanne d'Arc, a young virgin, but at the same time very cruel, who wouldn't stop and who would stab you in the back. Yeah, no problems, even if you are her mom. Then I will tell you who I compare this fragrance, who associate this fragrance with in the cinematograph. And Let's start to talk about fragrances which are similar to Gucci Envy. Gucci Envy often compared with two main fragrances. One of them is Diorissimo by Christian Dior, and another one is Chanel No. 19 from House of Chanel. Diorissimo from Christian Dior was created in 1956, and the author of the fragrance is Edmond Rudnitska. I have an empty bottle, and because the atomizer of this bottle was broken, I moved it to to a simple atomizer, generic one, to keep the scent, and I still keep the bottle. The interesting fact that after 2 or 3 years, the empty washed bottle still smells the same. That's interesting for me. I don't need to spray Diorissimo anywhere. Diorissimo is quite a strong fragrance, and the main ingredient of this fragrance is, not ingredient, the idea, main idea of this fragrance is Lily of the Valley, which is in French called Muguet. Thank you very much. One of my watchers gave me the right pronunciation of Muguet in French, Muguet. It's a lily of the valley, and Muguet was a favorite flower of Christian Dior. And after Edmond Rudnitska created Diorissimo, Christian Dior said that this is scented expression of his soul. I think it was an interesting fragrance of its time, because it was after war time, and if you look at after war Europe, if you look at after war Russia, you will see that women played a very important role in the society. For example, in countries like Germany and Russia, where men population was killed at war, both countries at a very high extent were developed by women. Yeah, so it was an emancipation which women probably didn't want, but it happened. And when this fragrance was issued, it was a cold, very clean, but at the same time very strong fragrance. Yeah, I think it's a sign of emancipation. It was a sign of emancipation of 50s. Yeah. And it still smells like a lady, and I heard this fragrance was one of the favorite by Princess Diana of Wales, and it's very ladylike. But when my perfume friends sniffed this version of Diorissimo, it's quite an early bottle. It's eau de toilette and it's super strong. They also felt a strong base of almond. It has some animalic, but it's a clean animalic note. And when you use it in a very hot weather, like when it's plus 37 Celsius, you feel how cold it is. I think it has aldehydes in this. And it's really, really cold in a warm climate. In cold weather, it's interesting as well, especially in the beginning of spring in the countries which have snow in the winter. This fragrance smells quite a early spring. It has a lot of facets, yeah, and it's definitely there is a similarity between Gucci Envy and Diorissimo because of this cold lily of the valley notes. However, Diorissimo doesn't have a metallic notes. It's not sweet. Gucci Envy is sweet. It has a sweetness of the pineapple fruit or whatever fruit. It's quite sweet, it's clean, it's mischievous, it's bold, and it's not ladylike. Yeah, this is a ladylike. It's still a woman of old tradition who will look after family, who will play her mother role mostly, and who would be a woman at home role. Yeah, if she has to go to work, if she has to do a career, it's not her choice. It's a circumstances of her life, even though she is very successful. She wouldn't do anything which would contradict the society. This one would do anything to get on top of the food pyramid. Yeah. Okay, I am not talking more about Gerissimo because this video is not about Gerissimo. I'm moving to the next one. The next fragrance which often compared with Gucci Envy, or Gucci Envy compared with, because this fragrance is more famous, is Chanel No. 19. I have a version in Eau de Parfum, and this bottle is from 1976 or 1979. And this bottle, this fragrance was created in 1970 when Coco Chanel was 87 years old, and number 19 in the name refers to her birth date of August 19. And this fragrance was created by Henri Robert, genius, every perfumer is genius, but yes, if you created something like this, you are genius, even if you didn't create anything else. Thank you very much, perfumers. You are super artists, bringing us such a pleasure in the life. Yeah, thank you very much. So I have it in a splash bottle, and Fragrantica call this fragrance as floral green, and it definitely has a galbanum, and you see the colors are all very similar. Yeah, Gucci Envy and Chanel No. 19. Shape of the bottle, very simple, minimalistic. This is Gerissimo. They all have similarity in color. Yeah. In the notes, is there any similarity in the notes? Yes, this fragrance is green as well. It has a citrus, it has a lily of the valley, it has a narcissus, but it's more considered as a green powder fragrance, more iris here than anything else. I would say more galbanum than iris, but from what we call flowers, I think iris is the strongest here. Also, it also has a oak moss, so it's hard to find the galbanum in this fragrance, but it's definitely here. So what's the difference with Gucci Envy? Chanel No. 19 is all, they are both greens. All these fragrances, three fragrances, are green. And you really feel a galbanum in both fragrances. You feel green notes in both fragrances. However, I wouldn't say that Gucci Envy is powdery fragrance. And Chanel No. 19, yes it is. I would say Gucci Envy is a metallic fragrance. And Chanel No. 19, no. It's not a metallic fragrance. It's more quiet. It's more natural. This is urbanist fragrance. This is a old good house, like a mansion lady. Yeah, this lady lives in a mansion, this lady lives in the city, in the apartment. This fragrance has a sweet note because of pineapple and other fruits. This is not a sweet fragrance at all. Some call this fragrance as a boardroom bitch. Sorry, I'm using such words. I normally try not to use them. However, I would say this is a bitch, but it's not a boardroom one. This one is not a ladylike. This is still a lady. I don't find this fragrance a BB, what I mean a boardroom B. I don't find it at all. For me, it's quite a classy. It's clean and innocent. I would not say this woman. She is distant, she is arrogant probably, she is cold, but she would not do anything unethical or anything unlawful. Yeah, this is an ethic in a bottle. There's no ethic in this fragrance. And this is unlawful. This woman or girl, this is a girl, she would do anything. She, what is good for her, to she would work with elbows, as we say in Russia, to move anything from her root, and she will climb on the pyramid, whatever it costs, yeah, to be on top, to be a queen. When I was thinking about these fragrances, three fragrances, I recall the movie with the name Mildred Pierce. Mildred Pierce is a movie which was made following the novel of James Cain, and it was a previous movie, a black and white movie with Joan Collins in the past, and HBO issued 5 miniseries of this movie recently with Kate Winslet in a role of the Mildred Pierce, emancipated woman who built her own business in a time when women were sitting at home. It's exactly what I was saying before, and I would say yes, she would probably wear Chanel number 19. Yeah, if you look at her character, it's quite strange. She loves only one person in her life, it's her daughter. But if you look how she treats male in her life, this is this way. Yeah. And if you look at her daughter, who is a talented coloratura soprano singer, she would probably be like this. I will leave a reference to the movie. You have to watch this movie if you like these fragrances. Why is that? Because when you see at the aesthetic of the movie, you will find exactly what I'm talking about. All the scenes with Mildred Pierce with of the mother, they refer to colors of Chanel number 5. They are green, they are natural, they are a little bit cold, and all the colors associated with the daughter in the movie, they relate to Gucci Envy. They are metallic, they are slightly plasticky synthetic, you know, like much more modern and at the same time less life. So the daughter is behaving like a poisonous snake, and I would associate this fragrance with a poisonous snake. Yeah, you may even feel a little bit high when you are poisoned by the snake. Oh yeah, I love it, I love it. And daughter at the same time is very clean, she's climbing to be a high society, whatever it costs, and she uses her mom to be there. Yeah, this is a difference between those two fragrances. So they are all three beautiful things, but if you want to give an impression you are a lady, a housewife, and stick to traditional values, this is yours, Diorissimo by Dior. If you go for the job interview and want to demonstrate yourself as a professional and as someone who is who can keep a distance very well, who will do her job, who is reliable and who is natural and ladylike, this is yours, number 19. And I don't think Gucci Envy is appropriate for work. It's very bohemian. I would wear one spray to work, but it's a B fragrance. Don't forget that when I am saying good words about this fragrance, I am having nostalgic value. I am having such a nostalgia associated with this fragrance. Many people who didn't try it at that time, they don't even understand. They smell it and say, oh, something like, oh, lily of the valley, yeah. No. I appreciated this as well. So, make a discount when discount to my words when I talk about this fragrance. But those who have the same nostalgic value as me, they understand why I love it, and you will see people looking for the dupes. Dupes do not exist for this fragrance. Neither Diorissimo nor Chanel No. 19 are quite a dupe for this fragrance. They miss a lot. They miss a fundamental idea of this fragrance. They miss this big character of it. Yeah? They miss the poisonous snake. Poisonous snake theme of this fragrance. So, what else is compared with this fragrance? I bought this one. It's fantastic, beautiful bottle. The name of this brand is Roberto Verino, Italian brand, and this fragrance name is Platinum. Have a look how beautiful is the bottle. Yeah. Back, and you see it is a hole here, and when you put it on, beautiful. And I bought this fragrance almost, it was almost blind buy. I still had a chance to try because I bought it from a collector who is my friend now, and I didn't really. So, this fragrance has a similar idea. It's a little bit of sweet, green, flowery. But this is a nice modern girl. Yeah, I think this fragrance probably is from 2000. So, it's a girl of now. It's not a girl of pre-millennium. It's a nice, clean, good for everyday wear, but it's not a poisonous snake. It's not. It's a good girl. So if you expect to buy this fragrance and use it as a dupe for Gucci Envy, you will not be satisfied. No. It's sweeter than say Chanel 19. It's warmer, it's nicer. This is a nice girl. So if there were two sisters in the family, looking very similar, same education, same social upbringing, same mom and dad, same house, same clothes, same everything. But one is nice, another is B. Yeah? So it would be the comparison between them. And I'm finishing now. I don't want this video to be 1 hour, as usual. I'd show you now what I found is a dupe for Gucci Envy. And I found this dupe from the dupe house, which doesn't exist on Fragrantica or anywhere else. So this is a dupe from Perfume Parlor. This is a company in UK which makes dupe oils. This is not oil, it's a spray in 50 ml bottle, and it smells exactly like Gucci Envy. Yes. Yeah. So if you cannot find, if all your attempts to find the Gucci Envy failed and you still want something not very expensive, look at this house. I bought it maybe 3 years ago. Just, I'm not buying normally dupes to have them as a dupes. You see, I have sufficient Gucci Envies, and I don't recommend you to buy dupes like this. Yeah. However, I don't think if you buy a Gucci Envy from this house would be any ethical issues, because the owner of Gucci Envy is not benefiting anymore from this fragrance. Yeah, they are not making money from Gucci Envy. So please feel free. I don't think it's unethical to buy something which was discontinued long time ago and you have a copy of this. Yeah. So this bottle is old, so I have it for few years now, and at that time they called it Gucci with double O NV0231. But if you go to their website, I will leave a reference under this video, you will find that under this number they sell the same fragrance under the different name. It's Florentine something, and the name is 0231. Yep, I will leave it under the video. Thank you very much for watching me. And apologies, I didn't appear for a long time with my reviews. I was celebrating my birthday. It's normally takes a few weeks for preparation and things. I don't really have time during that time for reviews. Yeah, and happy Gucci Envy. If you are going to buy them, I hope you will find a good version in a nice bottle and at a reasonable price. Thank you. I would appreciate if you can leave your opinions, if you had a Gucci Envy in the past and if you like it, or you didn't have it and discovered it recently and love it, or you never was attracted to it in the past, or you tried it recently and you didn't like it. So all opinions would be appreciated. I would really, really love them. Thank you very much. Bye. Svetlana with you.